Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. As you can see, new camera, new stand, which you can't see, but I'm trying to switch things up a little bit. So tell me what you think about this location. Anyways, last week I've been on vacation and maybe you could see some of my sketches on Instagram, but I also have a couple of Procreate process recordings. So I thought it would be nice to go through those. Let's see. I did several sketches during this vacation, but only three of them were on Procreate, well, on my iPad, and I use Procreate for them, so I can show off the process for those. This first one I actually didn't finish, but it was a fun one, and I just started it when I got there. So I got there earlier with my girlfriend, and we were just waiting for the rest of the crew to arrive, and there were some comfortable looking rocks in front of the cabin, and I thought, oh, let's just sit there and sketch what I see there. And guess what? The rocks in the end weren't comfortable at all, but at least it helped me a little bit in drawing. Well, it didn't help me, but it was a good place to sit at. Anyways, as you can see, I started to clean this up a little bit too early. It's not even a little bit too early. It's just I shouldn't have bothered with cleaning this up because the rough lines in the end were really fine. And after I felt again that everything just started to be a little bit too stiff, I just reverted back to my rougher pencil sketches in Procreate. This is basically the 6B pencil sketching from Procreate that I adjusted a little bit so to my industrial designery needs. And I also thought, okay, let's give this some quick colors. So I went into, I think I was using Cynix's brushes. Check him out on YouTube. And they're actually quite fun. I worked some more on them later, you will see in another video. But yeah, I was just trying to grab all the colors, and that the sun was slowly going down, so there was this really nice backlit area of the trees that you can see, and the sun was also hit by it. But then slowly my friends arrived, so I stopped this video and I thought I'll go sit down and continue it or finish it, but I never got around to that one. So hey, this is what you see. So this next one is one of these mornings or evenings. I'm actually not quite sure. I think it was one of the evenings where, because there was not natural light. Yeah, there was the inside house. So I don't know, but two of the folks were playing either Magic the Gathering or Rummy. And I was just sitting at the same table and I thought like, oh, this would be a perfect opportunity to try one of those fisheye lenses, you know, the wide angle lens sort of perspective. Since I haven't done this in quite a while, and I don't know why I was looking at comic books or what, but I thought, okay, let's go with a blue pencil, and if I like what I'm doing, I'm just going to use it as an underlay and go over it with a proper black line. And guess what? I didn't go over it with a black line because I really enjoyed the aesthetic of the blue pencil. While I wanted to keep this just the lines itself, after a while I decided maybe let's go in and do the whole, like give it a blue shade to all of it. As in, like, usually I go in with the grays, but since the lines were blue, I thought, okay, let's keep this whole blue aesthetics, give it a blue underlay, then I can go in with some darker blue into the shadows, and with some white pencil just go on top of the whole thing and give it a little bit of that highlight. I also multiplied the line layer to give a bit more pop and contrast to the lines because they were started to fade into the background a little bit there as well. In the end, I was quite satisfied with this one. As I said, it's been a while since I drew like a proper fisheye perspective anything. So it was just interesting setting it up and deciding for yourself how much you're going to exaggerate the bends of the lines and whatnot. And then the last drawing that I'm going to start in a second now was basically just a tree. So in front of the house were these really cool trees, and I thought like, okay, it would be worth trying to do a realistic study at least of one of the trees. And then I just went out and sat down. It was a really nice sunny day, and I started painting everything, not just the tree. I wanted to concentrate on the tree, but in the end, I was just like, okay, all the background and everything, make it nicer. And I tried to make a little bit of a study out of it. Actually, it was really fun doing the whole atmospheric perspective thing again, which since I don't paint that much, I don't do it that often, which just says, yeah, I need to paint more often. But then painting the trees itself themselves was really fun, especially since I don't know from where, but some time ago I downloaded some foliage brushes for Procreate and they just sped the whole process up tremendously. But yeah, so this was my vacation. It was up in the Romanian mountains, and we just went around with some friends, ate some really nice food, and just had some good times. So yeah, that's all I wanted to show you in this video. Hope you enjoyed it, hope you liked the process. If you'd like to see more content like this, feel free to subscribe to this channel. You can also follow me on Instagram if you would like to see more drawing related stuff, especially concept arty stuff. And make sure that you guys have a great week, and see you folks next time. All right, bye-bye.